Hello, good people. Welcome back again to another episode of Raw Talk with Ndinda. So today I would like to talk about this pressure, this unnecessary pressure that is coming from social media. My people, live according to your means. Live a life that you can only afford. If the only life you can afford is living in a bedsitter, kama hii yangu, live in a bedsitter. What's the need of renting an apartment that you're supposed to pay 20,000 and your salary is 15,000 to please friends, to please social media, to please fans? Now what's the need? If the only rent that you can afford ni ya kuishi kwa mabati, ishi kwa hiyo mabati proudly. Ishi kwa hiyo mabati. There is no need of nini. There is no need of kufurahisha watu huko nje, yet you are the only one who knows how much you are struggling to live that life. Live the life you can afford. Don't let social media trigger you into living a fake life. Don't let social media trigger you into living a life that you cannot afford. Don't live out of means. Live according to your means. Stick to your lane. If the only thing you can afford for breakfast ni ile kilalo, ile ugali na chai, take that one. It's not a must to eat bacon. Ama zinaitwaje hizo maomelette ama ndoni. If the only thing you can afford for breakfast ni ugali ya usiku na turungi, eat that thing and go to work and go to hustle. Do not live a life of impressing people or fans or social media. Toko na teseko ko peke yako paying those loans that you take to impress social media. Those loans that you take to impress people that don't even know you in person. So live the life you can afford. Hustle as much as you can. Usikatae kuza mtumba, sabu unashanga watu watasemaje. If the only job you have ni kuza mtumba, uze hiyo mtumba, pay your bills through selling that mtumba. Kama kazi yenye unaweza fanya ni ya mjengo, do not fear anyone. Go ahead and do that mjengo work. Because you are the only one who knows the kind of work that you can do to put food on the table. Do not do anything to impress people. Do not take loans to live a life, to live a fake life. Do not take loans so that you can impress people, so that you can impress friends, so that you can impress people on social media. Those people would be there to talk so they could pay some loans. You'll be there. Our auctioneers, they'll be there in your house taking everything that you... Taking everything that you bought with that loan, and you'll be left there. Which machine ways you afford, you'd be left there, and you'll be so ashamed, and you'll have to go back to that mabati house in Yungishi Kitambo before moving into that apartment and you're gonna 100K. Na mshahara yako ni 10K, surely. Ishi maisha yenye unaweza afford bana. Hii maisha ni fupi kuishi ukiimpress watu huku nje. If the only thing, kama ni nguo, kama nguo yenye unaweza afford ni nguo ya 200, why do you have to go for the tacky clothes that range from 7,000 and above? Eti sabu sakole yako, the sakole yako iko na watu wenye wanavaa nguo za tacky. Vaa hiyo dress ya 200. Vaa hiyo kiatu ya 50 bob. Hiyo shati ambao, vaa hiyo and be proud of who you are. You know, you are like a work in progress. So be proud of yourself. Appreciate yourself. Congratulate yourself on the little moves that you make. Ukianzisha kabisa hata kama unauza nini, be happy. And enjoy the little moves that you're making. Usifanye watu, usikubali watu wafanye ukufe na stress ama uchukue loans to live a fake life, to impress people. Takufa tu hapo na mashida na loans. We will be nowhere to pay your loans. Na sisi ndo unafikiri na to impress. I hope I'm clear.